Hello everyone, my name is Shankamuffin for all you don't know, and I've always wanted to unbox a knife ever since I've started playing CSGO in high school. It's been about 7 years, 6 or 7 years since I've started playing this game, so let's get into the video of me unboxing a knife after all this time. In this case unboxing, I'll be unboxing 150 cases, 25 of which would be the Prisma 2, 25 would be the Danger Zone, and 100 would be the Chroma 2. Obviously, we're looking for the M4 skin from this collection, as well as the Bullet Queen. In addition to this, you do have the Talon knives in this collection, as well as the Yurcees knives, I think. Yurcees, I think that's how you pronounce it. And the Navaha, one of those two. And the Stiletto knife. So that's from this collection. Next up is the Danger Zone case. Again, 25 of these. We're looking for the AK Asimov. StatTrak factory new is going for like $800 right now. Rarer than a knife, but still pretty cool if I would be able to get that. And everyone's favorite pastel goth collection is the Neo-Noir. Honestly, really love the op skin a lot. Again, in this collection, there are knives. It's the same thing as before, just different finishes. So the Stiletto, Talon knife, etc. Just different finishes on it. Last case up on the list is the 100 Chroma 2 cases. The reason why I'm doing this case is just because of the AK lead build. It is a blue rarity, given of how you have an 80% chance of rolling a blue. And these guys, they're worth like a minimum $1.50. like $1.75, so you can make some decent money back as well. In addition to that, obviously the Hyper Beast would be pretty sick to get. And honestly, the Neon Rider, to me, I like it a lot because I do like the Hotline Miami series, and it reminds me of that synth wave type of vibe, so I definitely enjoy that a lot. But I think the most important thing about this, of why I wanted to unbox this case, is because of the knives. And these knives are 100% the coolest knives in the set. You got the Bayonet Marble Fade, Bayonet Tiger Tooth. Just the Bayonet in general is my favorite type of knife, as well as you got the Flip Knives, which I had way back in the day. You got the Gut Knife, obviously not that great. No one really cares about those. But dude, the Karambits, the Tiger Tooth, the Doppler, the Ultraviolet, the Rust Coat, the Vasquez Steel. I think they're all great ones. The M9 Bayonet, Big Boy Bayonet knife, really do think they're prime as well. So I think these knives, as well as these finishes, are why I went for the Chroma 2. Because I get back the money from the AKs, as well as if I were to roll a knife, well, I definitely get something that I'd enjoy because of how flashy these are.
All right.
What might make it easier is the fact that there's 8 per row, by the way.
Right, I didn't know that at first until after counting. So, all right, 14, here we go. First case, guys. And our first case gives us a StatTrak. StatTrak, though. So field test. Yeah. Trimmy, 1 through 9.
7.
7.
Second from last.
Yeah.
Oh! Damn, that was close.
Yo, Trimmy, you almost got me, man. You almost got me.
Start smacking him off the desk.
Oh my god. Trimmy, go again. Which one you want?
Two.
Two. All right. So we're gonna, you know, we're gonna shake the case a little bit. We gotta, you know, touch the padlock just a tad. Oh, okay. All right. Open it. What do you get?
Watch you get battle scarred now because you shook the case.
Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, dude, this is actually pretty cool looking, dude. This is factory new as well. I actually really like the look of this one. I like that one. I like that one. All right. The very last one. 1 through 4. I gotta go with 2. My guess, it's gonna be a Desert Eagle. That is my guess. And the last one is, it's P250. We have opened 150 cases. So that means we are officially done with case opening.